Today we have amplifiers, 100 watt heads, 200 watt heads, and we've got an EVM 12 cabinet. Those speakers are the best Series 2 from the 70s. Best EVM L speakers they ever made. I don't care what anybody says, including Joe Bonamassa. These are SRO 15-inch speakers from the 70s, 1974. The SRO 15-inch speakers, 150-watt rating. Both these cabinets are 16 ohms. We're going to test it out through the Holy Grail guitar series, which is, this is a Coca-Cola top on all one piece of walnut. The whole guitar, everything is one piece of wood. There's no fingerboard glued on. It's a slab guitar, but it has a beautiful Coca-Cola glued on top. Fantastic. And we're going to check it out through all three of these amps. That's the first thing we're going to do. Let's give it a listen. Okay, let's do the Granger now. Same riff through the 212. Sorry. Let's do the 73 vintage Marshall. I'm going to do the Santa Cruz again because I wasn't playing so cleanly when I first started. All right, now we're going to do the 215 SRO cabinet. Santa Cruz through the 215s. Okay, the Granger through the 215s. The Granger now through the 215s. Okay, now the Marshall through the 215s. Okay, now the Santa Cruz through the 215s and the 212 EVs. Okay, now the Marshall through the 212 and the 215. So here's where the Santa Cruz really shines now. We're going to play just a little couple measures of lead guitar through each head now. And the Santa Cruz has this overdrive channel, okay, that gives you not only a decibel boost, but an increasing gain. It's really articulate and clear gain, and it's non-muddy. It's just it's like a super Marshall. Beyond any Marshall I've ever had. That's why Charlie built this amp for me, the Rushmore Holy Grail, for my guitars and for my company. So, but anyway, we'll try out all three heads through the 215 and the 212 cab so you can get an idea. So that's the now look, I'm gonna go into the I'm gonna step on the overdrive channel. Watch this. Like a, I don't know, 5 or 6 decibel boost. And as you can see, I don't have the amp up all the way. Because if I back the masher off that much, I get this nice graphic sound out of it without distortion in the lower frequencies or the mid frequencies. It cleans it up so I can get the sweet, sweet sound. I adjust it that way. Same thing with the overdrive channel. I've got it on almost 4. And, you know, the difference is, you know, it's not much difference, but it's definitely, it just sends it into amazing. You can get more volume out of it, more gain out of it. And it's just killer. All right, so let's do the grinder through the little bit of soloing through the 15 and the 12 as we can. And let's get that happening right now. Just massive, 200 watts. It's just got the biggest bottom end of all the amps. It's crazy, nutty, nutty, insane. It is a mammoth monster amplifier. The Marshall is amazing. So I EQ'd all the amps to the Marshall in a way. You know, once I got the Marshall, the sweetest it can sound, and that's it right there. You know, the volume up a little bit, spike in there on the treble volume, then the bass volume, and jumping the channels together. And, you know, the Marshall's kind of a one-trick guy like that. So once it's beautiful. You know, that's your sound live. You can't. Like in the studio, you can back off for the rhythms to clean up the rhythms a little bit, you know. But, you know, I don't have a switch for it. So when you're live, you set it like that because it sounds so good on the soloing that you know, that's how you set it. And then with the grinder, I just tried to get it to sound like this, you know, just messing with the, you know, the presence and everything. And the presence is all the way up. So, I mean, the presence here is almost all the way up. But, you know, I did that to get it to kind of sound like the Marshall. And the harmonics are very close, as you can tell. But this has way more bottom end. It's just massive, tubby bottom end. It's, you know, 200-watt Haybauer transformer. That's why that sounds the way it does. And then this guy, you know, with the overdrive channel, like the rhythms can be super clean. You've got so much control, you know. Once you get your rhythm sound, which is right here with these dumble switches, and right here with this, you know, you have the bright switch down in the middle is off and then up is bright. And, you know, it just sounds so good. And same thing here with the jazz rock thing. It adds big bottom end to it. And I really like it. overdrive channel. It really, you know, it really sings on the lead guitar. And that's the things that the Marshall can't do, is that this, you know, has this foot switch, and you can just, when you go to solo, man, you're going to get, and it's not all the way up, it'll get even louder on the solos. You can go, you can crank it, and it's just like crushing the world. You got all this drive. This is all gain control. It's just outstanding. And, you know, I'll try it with the pedals in a few days. But it's just an amazing amp. I'm so happy with the Charlie Plate's Santa Cruz sound, the Rushmore Holy Grail amp, man. I'm just so blessed by this thing.